Good morning, students. Hope all of you are taking care of yourself and are fit and fine, right? So today we are going to start a new part, and today we are going to learn about the retirement of partner, right? When a partner is going to leave a firm, right? Generally, a partner can leave a firm when a situation like this arises. Number one, he is unable to control the activities of business, or he is no longer interested in taking the activities of the business. Number two can be that he is finding it financially difficult to give up more time, more money, and in addition, it might be that he might be aged and he is not able to give enough time to the business. In that reason also, he might leave it. Or there can be many other reasons also for which a partner can seek for retirement. There can be a very prominent one reason, the third one, that is a conflict among the members. Okay, among the partners, there can be any fight or quarrel or argument. Because of that, also a partner can decide to retire from a business. So, retirement of a partner from a partnership firm is simple. What is the meaning of that? Retirement from the partnership firm means the partner is going to withdraw back his money. He is going to take away all what he has given in the business, and he is going to say goodbye to the business, right? That is called retirement of business. Okay, retirement of partner from the business. Clear? Okay, so today we are going to learn about the retirement of partner. Now I'm going to share you a file where I'm going to talk about certain methods or steps which you are going to take for solving the problems of retirement of partner. It's very simple. Okay, it is not very complicated. It's very simple. Once you have understood admission of partner, retirement of partner will go along with the concept of admission of partner. Clear? So it is not very difficult. Only thing is that you have to be very much aware of few concepts, like when a partner is going out from the business, what are the things he is going to get, and what are the things we should take into care while settling his account. Okay, those are the concepts you need to know. Other than that, it is not very difficult. Okay, clear? Let's start.
So first of all, we'll see the steps in the retirement of partner. Okay, so basically the common steps between retirement of partner and admission of partner are the transfer of accumulated profit, reserve, losses to the partner's capital account. Okay, that is the same like admission of partner. Okay, there is some similarities between admission of partner and retirement of partner. In both the cases, what is happening is that the partnership agreement is reconstituted. Okay, so due to that, what happens is that you will have to settle the changes that is going to happen. Okay, and before changing the agreement, you have to settle all the reserves, all the profits, all the losses, all the change in the value of assets and liabilities, as well as the value of goodwill. Okay, so that concept in the admission and retirement remains the same. Okay, so that is why the first step in retirement of partner is same like admission, that is transfer of all accumulated profit, reserves and losses. Okay, either it is profit or loss, whatever it is, all things will be transferred to the partner's capital account in old ratio. Okay, all the partner's capital account. That means all the partners are the old partners. So that is why we will use the old ratio, right? The next step will be to prepare the revaluation account, where we'll show the changes in the value of assets and liabilities. And after that, we will find out whether there is profit or loss. And the profit or loss will also be transferred to all the partners' capital account in their old ratio, right? The third step comes the calculation of goodwill. Here you have to find out what is the goodwill of the firm, and then you have to find out what is retiring partner share of goodwill, right? Once you have got retiring partner share of goodwill, then you can go for finding the finding the change in the ratio. Okay, that is either a partner is gaining or sacrificing. In most of the cases, the continuing partners are gaining, but sometimes if they change the ratio totally, then sometimes it might be seen that a continuing partner is sacrificing and the other continuing partner is gaining. Okay, so continuing partner means those partners who are going to continue the business after retirement of a retiring partner. Clear? So it can happen that after the retirement, the ratio might appear in such a way that one partner will gain, another one will sacrifice. Or in most of the cases, the situation is found to be like the partners are gaining. Okay, instead of having gain and sacrifice, in most of the cases is found that they are gaining. Right? Then comes the next one. What we will do after you have got the retiring partner share of goodwill? Okay, then calculate the. Once the calculation has been done for the gaining ratio and sacrificing ratio, we know the formula for that. Gaining ratio equals to what? Gaining ratio equals to, it is new ratio minus old ratio, right? That is, the new ratio is more than the old ratio, then it is gaining. And if we are going to find out sacrificing ratio, then it will be what? Old ratio more than the new ratio. So old ratio minus new ratio, right? So you can use any of the formula, and if the answer comes in negative, it will be opposite of what you are finding, right? So then at last, once you have got the ratio, what you will do, you will find out who is gaining, who is sacrificing. Accordingly, you will make the entry like this: gaining partners capital account debit to retiring partners capital account, and sometimes it can be to sacrificing partner also. If there is any sacrificing partners, then his account also will be, his account also will be credited. Okay, clear? His capital account also will be credited. So this is how your treatment of goodwill will appear. Okay, so till now we have seen that most of the steps are matching, except this one where we are finding out the retiring partner share and we are giving him. Why the gaining partner's capital account is debit? Because he is going to take the share of whose? The one who is retiring. Okay, so that is why, since he will take the share, that means he will have to pay for that. So when he will pay, his capital account will be debit, right? And when it is paid to the retiring partner, the retiring partner's capital will increase, so it will be credit. Okay, after that we have to pay the interest on capital if it is there, or salary to partner, or commission to partner. Okay, as we have done in our first chapter. Okay, profit and loss appropriation we have done there, right? In the same way we have to do it. No need to prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Directly you have to give interest on capital, salary, commission, all these things if it is there. Okay, and also share of profit if the partner, retiring partner, is retiring in the middle of the year or in between the account, before the year ends. If he retires, then you have to find out how much is the amount of profit or loss that is accruing for the time period. Kitna profit ya loss banta hai us time period ke liye jitne din usne kaam kiya hai. So accordingly you have to give that much amount of profit to the retiring partner. Okay, then transfer the drawings as well as interest on drawings to the retiring partner's capital account. We'll give the drawings as well as interest on drawings to the retiring partner. Okay, and finally you will balance the capital account. Okay, drawings and interest on drawings basically will appear in the debit side because it is deducted from the amount. It will not be given, it will be deducted. Okay, it will be given in the capital account, but it will be deducted from the capital. Obviously it will be posted in the capital account debit side. That means it will be deducting the capital, reducing the capital, right? After that, finally the balance, the balancing will be done of the capital account of whose? Of the retiring partner, and you will pay him off. Now the settlement, for settlement of the partner's, retiring partner's capital account, you will have many options. First option is, if you don't, the first option is, if you don't have enough cash, one is that situation. The other situation is when you have enough cash. The third situation is when you are making some portion of payment in cash and some portion in loan account, means whole of the payment is not made at a time. Okay, so let's see the first situation, when you have enough cash and you are making the payment in cash. So if you have enough payment and if you are making the payment in cash, it will be retiring partner's capital account closed, so it will be debited. Retiring partner's capital account debit, to cashier bank account. Okay, that is what you are. This is a situation where you have the money and you are making the payment in full. Okay, when the payment is made in cash, in the bracket as mentioned, in full, matlab pura puri settlement ho gaya. Okay, there will be another situation when you don't have enough money. Okay, and you find that it is better that if I pay him later. Okay, if you feel like I will pay him later, in that case, what you can do is that, in that case, what you will do, you can choose to transfer the amount of money due to the loan account. Okay, instead of paying him cash or bank, you can transfer it to the loan account. In that case, it will be like this. The journal entry will appear like this: retiring partner's capital account debit. Okay, it will be closed, and a new liability will arise in the place of capital. That is, it will be retiring partner's loan account. It is taken as current liability, right? Retiring partner's capital account debit to retiring partner's loan account. This is nothing but the amount of money that is payable to the retiring partner. Now coming to the next one, when a part of the payment, like suppose you have to pay 10,000 to the retiring partner. Out of that 10,000 rupees, suppose you are paying 2,000 in cash. Okay, 2,000 rupees you are paying in cash, and rupees 8,000 you are not able to pay now, so you will transfer in the loan, right? So how will you show that? In that case, what you will do is that retiring partner's capital account will be debited by 10,000. I'm just giving an example. Okay, there's no specification of this amount. It can be any amount, no problem, doesn't matter also. So then retiring partner's capital account debit 10,000, and since I'm able to pay only 2,000, so 2,000 will be in the cash. Okay, and the remaining, just a minute, I'm putting it here, and the remaining unpaid amount of 8,000 we will show it in the loan account, right? We will show it in the loan account. So that is why this type of entry will have their own importance. It will be shown in the nature of the need, means how the need will arise, according to that only you have to show it. Clear? Again, I'm repeating this part. When the payment is made in part, that is when part payment is done, that means part payment means both you are able to pay some amount of money, but the remaining amount you are not able to pay. That means both cash as well as loan account will be there. So when the payment will be done, what will happen? Retiring partner's capital account debit 10,000 to cash or bank account 2,000 to retiring partner's loan account 8,000. Okay, this is how the picture will appear to you at the time of settlement. After that, you can do the balancing for the rest of the partners, and you can prepare the balance sheet as it is required. Okay, now I'll show you a performer specimen of retiring partner's capital account. The retiring partner's capital account will appear to you in this format. Obviously, it is of T-shape, and the retiring partner's capital account will be like any other capital account. As a whole, you can prepare, but what are the things they are going to get, and what are the things they are going to pay to the firm? Let's see at the time of retirement. First of all, he will get the opening balance. This is the opening balance of cash. Sorry, opening balance of capital. Opening capital, whatever it is having, or balance of capital. In fact, better than opening, I should say balance of capital. Whatever balance is there in the capital account. Then reserve fund, whatever the reserve is there, okay? Reserve or any fund it is there, whatever fund, investment fluctuation fund, reserve fund, workman compensation fund, okay, those all things. Then profit and loss account, obviously what is in the appearing in the liability side, that is the credit balance, right? Then revaluation profit. After that, you are going to give the share of goodwill, and this share of goodwill is given through gaining partner's capital account. How come? We know that by this particular entry. Just a minute. Yeah. Gaining partner's capital account debit to retiring partner's capital account. That means retiring partner's capital account credit side, right? Retiring partner capital account credit side. What will you write? By gaining partner's capital account, right? By gaining partner's capital account, the share of goodwill, clear? Then if he is supposed to get salary, interest and capital, commission, that will be given. And at last, if there is any share of profit, that also will be given. Clear? Once all this payment has been done, then what will happen? The balancing will be done and it will be settled. But remember, you have to pay something. If you are paying the partner something, you are supposed to deduct also something from him. Let's find out what we can deduct. The first thing is the debit balance of current account. If the current account is showing debit balance, that should be deducted. Okay, that should be deducted from the account. Now the capital account, if the current account is showing credit balance, that should appear here in the credit side. But if it is showing debit balance, then it will appear here. Okay, that will appear here. After that, drawings will be charged from his account. Interest on drawings will be also charged from his account. The share of loss on due to current year, that will also be coming here. Revaluation loss will come. Advertisement suspense account will come. Profit and loss debit balance will come. Okay, all the debits, all the things that is going to reduce the capital will come in the debit side. After that, finally, you do the balancing, and whatever the balance will be there, that will be either paid in cash. Cash means either cash payment or bank through bank. That's the same thing. Okay, either you paid in cash, or will be combination of cash and loan, or will be only loan. Okay, it can be anything depending on the situation. You have to understand that. Okay, I hope all of you understood this concept. Okay, this is very, very important and primary concept. Fine. Now, as we have decided about the steps, we will slowly start all the things. But first of all, you should know how to calculate the new ratio in case of retirement of partner. So we'll start with the new ratio, calculation of new ratio at the time of retirement of partner. Okay, so what is there? Calculation of new profit sharing ratio. So in calculation of new profit sharing ratio, one simple concept that lies is there. If the new ratio is not given, okay, suppose after the retirement, the new ratio of the partners are not given, then what you will do? The old ratio of the old partners, of the continuing partners, okay, the old ratio of the continuing partners will become the new ratio, as well as the gaining ratio also. Okay, both gaining ratio and the new ratio. Let's take an example and explain the concept. X, Y, and Z are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5:4:3. Okay. And we are asked to calculate the new ratio when X retires. If X is retiring, what is the new ratio? If Y retires, what is the new ratio? And if Z retires, what is the new ratio? Now, here the new ratio is not told, but Y, X, and Z, okay, X, Y, and Z, their ratio is told 5:4:3. So in the first case, what is happening? X is retiring. That means the 5 share is going on. Okay, going out. The 5 share is going out. So what is remaining? 4:3. So the new ratio of Y and Z after X retirement. The new ratio of Y and Z after X retirement will be 4:3. Here you can see when X is retiring, the new ratio will be, since X is retiring, so the new ratio between Y and Z will be 4:3, excluding X. Now if Y is retiring, in the second case, if Y is retiring, that means this 4 portion is going out. That means what do we have? 5:3. So the new ratio will be 5:3. Clear? Are you getting the concept? I'm repeating once again. If the new ratio is not given after the retirement, then the old ratio will be taken as a new ratio as well as the gaining ratio. Now let's take the example of Z. If Z is retiring, that means this 3 portion is not there. So 5:4 will be the 5:4 will be the new ratio as well as the gaining ratio. Right? Now here it's told only about the new ratio, but I'm still mentioning about the sacrificing or gaining ratio. Okay, so that you can understand the concept also very nicely. Now coming back to the next question, that is illustration number 2. What do we have here? A, B, and C are partners, and they're sharing the profits in the ratio of 1/2, 1/3, and 1/6. Now in this case, you can see the denominators are not same. So first and foremost thing will be, make the denominator same, right? Then comes, find out the new ratio if B retires. What will be the new ratio if B is retiring? So if B is retiring, that means who is B? This 1/3 one, right? Clear? But you should know that first of all, you have to make all the denominators same in this case. You cannot just simply remove 1/3 and you can say the 1:1. No. Why? You cannot say that because the denominators are not same, right? So what will you do in this case? What you will do is that first of all, make the denominator same. How will you make? By taking the LCM. So you can see that here they have taken in this process. You can follow any process of doing that. and ultimately the new ratio comes to 3:2:1. 3:2:1. So this 3:2:1 is referring to the new profit sharing ratio. The old ratio, right? From here we can find out the new ratio. So what will be the new ratio now? A:B:C was 3:2:1. That means B was having 2 share. So after B's retirement, the new ratio will be 3:2:1, right? Because B was having 2/6. So if we exclude 2/6, then we will have 3:1. Once again, I'm repeating, A:B:C was 3:2:1. So if we exclude B share, then it will be 3:1. So the new ratio will be after B's retirement, it will be 3:1 for A and C, right? Then next one, P, Q and R are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 1:1:2, 2:5 and 1:10. Find out the new ratio if P retires. So if P is retiring, what is the new ratio? As I told you, make the denominator same. So once you make the denominator same, you can see that the new ratio is 5:4:1. Now it's not a new ratio, it is the adjusted ratio. So now the adjusted ratio is 5:4:1. Of course, P, Q and R, right? So P was having 5/10, Q was having 4/10 and R was having 1/10. So now who is retiring? P. So P is going out. That means what is the new ratio? 4:1, isn't it? 4:1. Is it clear? Okay. So that is the concept given here. So I hope you understood this. Okay. Now we will take up a new question for understanding this new ratio, then gaining ratio in a proper way. Okay, gaining ratio also I'll show you, but before that we'll explain this. A, B and C are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 5:4:3. Okay, A, B and C are partners and their profit sharing ratio was 5:4:3. That means 5/12, 4/12, 3/12. Now B is retiring. B is leaving the business and his share was divided equally between A and C. Okay. That means A and C took half of what? Of B share. B share was how much? 4/12. Isn't it? As I told you, 5/12, 4/12 and 3/12 was the share. So B will get take how much? 4/12. So this 4/12 share. Okay. 4/12 share will be taken by A and C equally. That means 1:1, isn't it? 1:1. So now it is told that calculate the new profit sharing ratio of A and C. So how will you do that? Let's find out. So B share will be divided between A and C, isn't it? B share will be divided between A and C in the ratio of 1:1. Okay. B share will be divided between A and C in the ratio of 1:1. Clear? That is clear because it is given here. His share will be divided between A and C equally. That means they will take half of B share. A will take half of B share. C will take. So let's find out what is the half of B share. So half of B share is how much? 2/12. Okay. So A is going to take 2/12. Same. B is also going to take 2/12. Right. Sorry. C is also going to take 2/12. So what will be the new ratio of A? A earlier was taking 5/12 plus now he is going to take 2/12. So the total share of A will become 7/12. In the same way, C was getting 3/12. Now C has got from B how much? 2/12. So 3/12 plus 2/12, it will become 5/12, right? 5/12. Clear? So the new ratio is again now how much? 7:5. That means 5/12, we can say 7:5. Okay, 7:5. And in this case, it is in the question, it is not told, but you should know that what is the gaining ratio? In which ratio A and C is gaining? In the ratio 1:1, equal ratio, because they are taking B share equally, so they are gaining equally. So the gaining ratio will be 1:1. I hope you understood. Okay. Let's take up next sum. Here what is told? It is told that A, B and C were partners sharing profits in the ratio of 5:4:3. Okay. A, B, and C are partners, and their profit sharing ratio was 5:4:3. Okay, it is told that C retired and his share was taken up by A and C. Okay, C retiring, C is going to leave the business, and now what will happen is that after C's retirement, A and B is going to take the profit sharing ratio as 3:2. Okay, no, and his share was okay. No, it is not told the new ratio. It is told that C was retiring and C's share will be taken up by A and B in the ratio 3:2. That means A will take 3/5 of C share and B will take 2/5 of C share. Now what was C share? 3/12, isn't it? C share was 3/12. So A will take how much? 3/12 into 3/5. And B will take how much? 3/12 into 2/5, right? So let's find out what is the ratio, in which ratio they are taking? 3:2. So what is the new ratio now of A? A is going to get, earlier A was getting how much? 5/12 plus how much is going to get from C? 3/5 of 3/12, isn't it? 3/5 of 3/12. So how much you will get? A will get 9/60. Clear? A is going to get 9/60, and earlier he was having 5/12. So 5/12 plus 9/60 is how much? 34/60. So A's new share is 34/60, right? 34/60. In case of B, now in case of B, B was getting how much earlier? 4/12, and now B is going to take how much? 2/5 of 3/12. So 2/5 of 3/12 is 6/60. 6/60. So ultimately, don't cancel it here. Ultimately, what we are finding it here is that earlier B was getting 4/12 plus 6/60. It comes to 26/60, isn't it? 26/60. So that means the new ratio is 34/60 is to 24/60, or you can say 34:26, isn't it? You can further deduct it and write down 17:13, isn't it? Because the common factor is going with a 2. So it will be 17:13. Clear? Then we will go to the next sum. That is illustration number 5. What is given here? A, B, and C are partners sharing profits in the ratio of 1:4:2:5:7:20. So whenever you find this type of fraction where the denominators are not same, please make it same before you go for solving the sum. So what happens here is that A retires and his share was taken up by B and C. Okay, A is retiring and his share was taken up by B and C. In which ratio? 1:2 ratio. Clear? 1:2 ratio. So here, what will be the new ratio we have to find out? So that means 1:2 means B is going to take 1/3 and C is going to take 2/3. Okay, and what will happen? Let's find out what was A share. A share was 1/4. You can just make the denominator same. That will make the sum more easy to understand. Okay, if you don't do also, it will not be difficult. But if you do, it will be more easy. Right? So try doing that. What will be the case here? It will be turning up like this. 5, it is going 4 times 20, right? So it will be 5 4 20. So 5 4 2 8. So it will be 8/20. Here it will be 5/20. Then again 5 here. So 5/20. Here it will be 5/20. Here it will be 8/20. Here it is 7/20. So the ratio comes to 5:8:7. If you do in your copy, you'll understand. 5:8:7. Clear? So what is happening here? A is retiring and his share was taken up by B and C. That means 5/20 share. 5/20 share will be taken by B 1/3. And C 2/3. Clear? So let's find out how much is the gain. You can do like this also, or you can do 1/3 of 5/20 also. 1/3 of 5/20, it will be how much? 1/3 of 5/20, it will be 5/60. So ultimately 5/60, if you cancel, it will come 1/12. Clear? That means B will get how much? Earlier B was getting how much? 2/5, that means 8/20, isn't it? 8/20. So 8/20 plus, instead of canceling, you can just go with the numbers also. So ultimately, if you add that 1/12 from here, you will get it how much? 29/60. Okay, 29 by 60. If you don't cancel here, you will get 5 by 60, isn't it? So if you do the same thing, you will get 29 by 60. Same way you have done in case of C also, and we get the new ratio as 29 is to 31, right? I'm not explaining in detail because the same thing we have done above also. Now we will find out the gaining ratio. In this case also, you can find out the gaining ratio. What is the gaining ratio? 1 is to 2, isn't it? Gaining ratio is the ratio in which the continuing partner is taking retiring partner share. Okay. So after that, the next one, that is illustration number 11. What is given here? A, B, and C were partners sharing profits in the ratio 2 by 6, 1 by 6, and 1 by 6. Right? A is retiring and the surrender. And what happens then? Surrenders. A is surrendering 2 by 3 of his share in favor of B. That means whatever A share is, out of that 2 by 3 will be taken by B, and remaining in favor of C. That means remaining how much? Out of, if 2 by 3 is given to B, that means what is the left? What is left here? 1 by 3, isn't it? Because out of 1, total share, if you take 1, and if I give 2 by 3 share to one person, the remaining share will be how much? 1 by 3, isn't it? So 1 by 3 will be taken by C. Now calculate the new ratio it is to. So, in which ratio A is going to surrender? Surrender means going to give the share to B and C in the ratio 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. That is 2 is to 1. Clear? So, that means what? A is gaining how much? A is gaining, B is gaining how much from A? 2 by 3 of 2 by 6. So, 2 by 3 of 2 by 6 is 2 by 9. And same way, C is gaining how much? 1 by 3 of 2 by 6, so 1 by 9. Isn't it? 1 by 9. So, just add up here. The old ratio of B was how much? 1 by 2. If you don't want to change it, if you want, then it will be very good. Okay, very good. If you change the denominator and make it the same. If you don't do also, you can go with the flow here. So what will happen? 1 by 2 plus the gain, that is 2 by 9. Ultimately, it will be 13 by 18. And in case of C, it was 1 by 9, the gain, plus the old ratio was 1 by 6. So 1 by 6 plus 1 by 9, it is coming 5 by 18. So the new ratio will be 13 is to 5. Isn't it? 13 is to 5. And the gain will be how much? How much they are gaining? 2 is to 1. Isn't it? Clear? So moving again to the next question. What we have here? This is also a continuation of gaining ratio, calculation of gaining ratio. We can see that 4 partners are there, A, B, C, and D. And their profit sharing ratio was 2 is to 1 is to 3 is to 4. Okay, that is 2 is to 1 is to 3 is to 4. And that means how much is the share? It is 2 by 10, 1 by 10, 3 by 10, and 4 by 10. So after that, what happens is that B retires. B is retiring, and what is happening here? And his share is acquired by A. Okay, B is retiring, leaving the business, and his share was taken up by A. Okay, A and C, both. Okay, A and C in the ratio 4 is to 1. That means 4 by 5 A will take, 1 by 5 C will take. Of whose share? B share, isn't it? So what was B share? 1 by 10. Clear? It was 1 by 10 here. So calculate the new profit sharing ratio and the gaining ratio. So 1 by 10, 4 by 5 will be how much? 4 by 5 of 1 by 10, A will get. So how much it will be? 4 by 5 of 1 by 10, 4 by 50. And 1 by 5 of 1 by 10, 1 by 10 will be C's. That means how much is that? 1 by 50. Clear? So this is the gain of A and C. That is the gaining ratio is 4 is to 1. Clear? Now what will be A's new share? A's new share will be, earlier he used to get how much? 2 by 10 plus 4 by 50. The new ratio is 14 is to 3, 14 by 50. Clear? 14 by 50. Then comes the next one. After that, who is the next one? It is C. So in case of C, because B has retired. So in case of C, what happened is that C was earlier getting how much? 3 by 10 plus, how much is the gain? Okay, 3 by 10 was the earlier ratio, and now the gain is 1 by 50. So ultimately it is coming 16 by 50, isn't it? The total gain is 16 by 50. So this 16 by 50 is the new ratio of C. But in case of D, what is happening? There is no change. 4 by 10 will remain 4 by 10. So just let's make the denominator same. 4 by 10, we can make the denominator same by multiplying with 5. 10, 5 is 50. So same way you have to multiply the numerator also. 4, 5 is 20. So it will be 20 by 50. So the new ratio will be 14:16:20. Okay, 14:16:20. And if you deduct it, it will come to, if you reduce it to the lowest term, then it will come to 7:8:10. Okay, 7:8:10. Clear? Then now comes the next illustration, that is illustration number 13. What is given here? P, Q, and R are equal partners in a firm. Okay, P, Q, and R are equal partners in a firm. R retiring from the business and the goodwill of the firm is valued this much, right? So next comes the goodwill treatment. So this goodwill portion I will show you in the next video. I want to explain you a little bit more about that before we go to the goodwill portion. This particular portion I am going to show you in the next video. Okay, the continuation will be there of this particular chapter. Okay.